Hello, thanks for coming to my presentation on object-based image analysis for ship detection in satellite imagery, a proof of concept for marine mammal studies, and a tool to monitor illegal fishing. In this context, very high-resolution satellite images, for example, of sub-meter resolution, allow monitoring of marine mammals without any risk to researchers and any disturbance to wildlife. Satellite images come at comparable costs to traditional surveys and allow access to remote regions. Concurrently with threats to marine mammals, illegal unreported and unregulated fishing, also known as IUU, threatens commercial fish stocks and non-target species, such as marine mammals. Detecting IUU vessels is considerably more complex in regions such as the Southern Ocean for its vastness, remoteness, and dangerous conditions. IUU monitoring can also benefit from the use of satellite images of slightly less resolution than the ones necessary for marine mammals, for example, of a few meters. However, analyzing satellite images manually demands a high amount of researcher hours. In this context, automated analysis can shorten the time for large-scale images. A considerable number of automated analysis studies have been carried out with pixel-based methods in satellite and unoccupied aerial systems. Nevertheless, pixel-based approaches have produced considerable amount of false negatives and false positives. The latter are of special concern in conservation efforts as they lead to overestimations in abundant surveys. Object-based image analysis comes as an alternative to pixel-based methods. It uses homogeneous groups of pixels instead of individual pixels as units of analysis. We obtained a satellite image of 3 meters resolution of the island of Capri, Italy, with a free planet research license. We performed our analysis in Google Earth Engine, an open access software for analysis of satellite imagery that allows to share code among users. We first clipped a section of interest of the image that did not contain any land. OVIA consists of two steps, segmentation and classification, and does not only take into account spectral information, that is color, but also size, shape, relative and absolute location, and boundary conditions. The segmentation divides the image into homogeneous groups of pixels. Those are clusters or candidate objects that you can see in the image above. After the image has been divided into clusters, the area, perimeter, standard deviation, width, and height were extracted from the clusters to be used as explanatory variables in the classification. Sample points were taken from 5 ships and 10 water clusters along with their explanatory variables and were manually assigned as ships or water as a response variable. The points were equally split between training and testing partitions, and a random forest algorithm was used for the classification. The testing of the classification results was carried out and the confusion matrix was built. No false positives and no false negatives were found in the confusion matrix. However, comparing our classification to our manual counts, out of 19 ships, 15 were recognized with OVIA. 3 were very small and were recognized as 1, and other 2 were not recognized. You can see the results of our classification in the image above. As conclusions, we have had a successful proof of concept of OVIA for recognition of objects in the sea surface applicable to marine mammals at higher image resolutions. We also have an application in monitoring of IUU fishing with high resolution but more accessible imagery. For example, acquirable through the Planet Research License or the USGS Explorer. This constitutes a low-cost tool for IUU fishing monitoring for government agencies, especially in remote regions such as the Southern Ocean. Finally, for both applications and others, we have an automated alternative to shorten analysis time of vast satellite images, and it can be freely performed in Google Earth Engine. The code access is in the link. Thanks again for watching my presentation. These are my references. Here is my contact information, and I look forward to talking with you